Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you what it's like to analyze data in Stata. So let's say that you're new to Stata and you've downloaded it and installed it on your machine and you're familiar with the interface, but you haven't actually analyzed any data yet. What I thought we would do is just walk through importing some simple data into Stata and then trying out some different analyses. So first thing I'm going to do, obviously, is I'm going to open Stata 15. I've already installed it here on my taskbar at the bottom, so I'm just going to click the Stata 15 icon. This will open Stata. Couple of ways I could get this Excel data into Stata. One is I could just copy and paste it. So if you just had something quick and wasn't really important and you just wanted to get the data in quickly and do a quick analysis, I can copy it, and then in Stata, in the toolbar here, I can click on Data Editor in Edit Mode, open this, and click Paste, and now my data are in Stata. Now, one disadvantage of this is I don't have the variable name, so if I wanted to be a little bit more systematic about this, I could actually go to File, and then select Import, and then I could select Import Excel Spreadsheet. And Stata will import all kinds of different data. I'm just using Excel here as an example. So I already have this file stored. So it's stored on my C drive. So I'm just going to click Auto XLSX and then click Open. And the Import Excel dialog box has some options here. One of them is import the first row as variable names. If I look at the preview here at the bottom, I can see that the first row is actually the first row contains the variable names. So I'm going to check this box here, and that looks better. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK, and I'm going to click Yes. Oh, this is because it's overwriting what I had already copied and pasted in. So notice when I used the dialog box, it echoed the command here in the results screen. So that's one of the nice things about using the dialog boxes in Stata is when you first begin, the dialog boxes can actually help you learn the command syntax. Even if you're not a dialog box person, this is a quick and easy way to learn the syntax. So now I have my data imported into Stata. So let's open the data editor again and take a look at it here. So now I have my variable names across the top and I can see my data. So if I scroll across here, there are some things that I would like to clean up a bit. For instance, gear ratio has all these decimal places hanging off the end left over from when it was imported. So I might want to clean that up and I may not want to round it. I just want to change the display format. So one thing I can do is I can select gear ratio here on the upper right panel where it says variables. And I'm going to select gear ratio. And I would like to change the storage format. So I'm going to select format, and there's a little box here with three dots in it. If I click that, now I could change the display format, excuse me. So I'd like to store this as a numeric variable in a fixed format, and I might want to store display this with two decimal places, total of 10 digits with two decimal places. I could change other features, but we'll save that for another day. So I'm going to click OK. And if I come across here now, gear ratio is stored, is displayed at two decimal places. Another thing that I might like to do is provide value labels for foreign. So if I come over here and select foreign, I can select label. Value label. That's what I'm looking for. And I don't have any value labels created yet. So I can create that again by clicking this little three dot box here. And then I'm going to click on create label. And I'm just going to call this foreign, and then I can start creating my value labels. So I have zeros and ones. I happen to know this in advance. So I have a value of zero, and I would like for that to be domestic. And then I'm going to click add. And then for a value of one, I would like for that to be foreign. And then I'm going to click add. So now I've created a labeling scheme called foreign with zero is domestic and one is foreign. I'm going to click OK. And I'm not completely done yet. I'm going to close this. And then next to value label here, if I click this little drop down, I can see that foreign is listed. So now I've labeled the variable foreign with the foreign labeling scheme. And if I scroll across and look at my data, I can see that foreign is now labeled as domestic and foreign. So that's how I can label the values of a categorical variable. Now, I might also want to create a new variable, so let's close this, and maybe I would like to create a new variable I'm going to go to Data, Create or Change Data, and then select Create New Variable. And maybe I'd like to create a new variable. This is auto data, so I have a variable called miles per gallon, or MPG. And maybe I'd like to convert miles per gallon to kilometers per liter. So I could create a new variable with the name KPL, for kilometers per liter. And I happen to know, if I click Create here, this opens the expression builder. And there are all kinds of things I can do with the expression builder, but here I'm just going to select variables and double-click MPG. And I happen to know that the conversion factor from miles per gallon to kilometers per liter is 0.425. So I'm going to type that in, click OK, and then click OK again. And now I have a new variable in my spreadsheet, in my data set, called KPL, which is here at the end of my data set. And if I want to label that, I could actually select KPL here. And again, I can go under Properties and give the variable the name kilometers per liter. So I could label it right there in the data editor. Okay, so I'm going to close that. Let's take a look at some things we can do to summarize our data and describe them. So the first thing I want to do here is go to Data and describe the data. I just want to see what the data look like. So let's click Describe Data in Memory or in a File. And if I don't select any variables, Stata assumes that I want to describe all of the variables. So I'm just going to leave everything the way it is and click OK. And if I scroll back up here, I can see that this data set contains 74 observations on 13 variables. And I can then see a list of the variable names, as well as how they're stored, their display format. If there are any value labels, they'll be displayed here in this column. Here's foreign that we just created. And then we also see our variable labels. If I wanted to, I might summarize the data. So I could click Statistics and go to Summarize, Tables and Tests, Summary and Descriptive Statistics. And then I'm going to just select Summary Statistics here. And again, if I leave the variables, I can select which variables I want to summarize. If I just leave this window blank, it will summarize all of the variables in the data set. And there are lots of options I could do here, but I'm just going to leave everything as it is and click OK. And this will then show me some summary statistics for the variables in my data set. Make is a string variable, so it shows zero observations, that's why. But then for each variable, I see the number of observations. Looks like I'm missing a little bit for rep 78. And then I see the mean, the standard deviation, the min, and the max. And so this is often useful for getting to know our data. I might also like to create some graphs. So for instance, I could go to graphics, and select histogram. And maybe I'd like to see a histogram for miles per gallon. So here's miles per gallon. And I'm just going to move this up here, click submit. So I can see a histogram of miles per gallon. If I wanted to, I could overlay a density plot, maybe a normal density. So I could check this, click submit. And that would overlay a normal distribution on my histogram. I'm going to cancel out of this. I might also want to see a pie chart, for instance, for foreign. So I can select graph pie here. And then for my categorical variable, I'm going to select foreign. And then click OK. And now I can take a look at a pie chart for foreign and domestic. I can graph variables by other variables. So for instance, I might go to graphics and select boxplot. And I could look at miles per gallon by foreign. So I can select miles per gallon here. And then in the categories tab, I could select a grouping variable, which in this case I want to use foreign. So I select foreign. And I'm going to click submit again so I can show you a fun trick. If I click submit, by the way, clicking submit just leaves the dialog box open. It runs the command, but it leaves the dialog box open. If I click OK, it runs the command and then closes the dialog box. So here I've created a box plot for miles per gallon by domestic and foreign cars. If I wanted to, I could go back to the main tab and select horizontal, and I could make this a horizontal box plot if I wanted to. So that's another fun graph I could do. So let's do some analyses. Let's come over here to statistics And let's say that I'd like to fit a linear regression model. So I'm going to go to linear models and related and select linear regression. And then for my dependent variable, I'm going to select MPG. And for my independent variables, one thing I could do is just select maybe weight and foreign. And this is one way I could do it. And I'm going to move this up here and click submit. And then this will run my regression command. And in the output, I can see, well, I see the command here, regress, followed by the dependent variable and then the covariates. And I see my ANOVA table and my F statistic and my R squared. And then the table below shows me my regression coefficients. Now here's a fun thing that I can do. If I want to create interactions between these variables, I can come over here and click this little three-dot box. And this will allow me to create all kinds of interactions and do all kinds of things with my covariates. So I just want to leave factor variables selected, and I'll explain what that is here momentarily. If I only wanted the main effects, I would just select the variables then. But in this case, I'd like to do a two-way full factorial model. So what that means is I'm going to select the variable weight of the car. And see right here, if I check that box, that tells Stata that I want to treat weight as a continuous variable. I don't want to add any kind of time series operators or anything like that. And then I also want to include the variable foreign. And once I have the foreign is a binary variable, so I'm not going to check the box under C. Now I'm going to click add to var list. And this has added this kind of cryptic looking syntax to my model, and I'll explain this in just a moment. If I click OK, this will now fit a model that includes the main effect of weight, the main effect of foreign, as well as the interaction between foreign and weight. So that's what this sharp-sharp or pound-pound, whatever you want to call it, notation means. It's Stata's factor variable notation. After I fit my model, I might want to graph this or calculate some predictions. Stata has what we call a estimation post-estimation paradigm. So I've just fit the model or estimated the parameters, and now I can do other things by clicking statistics. After I fit the model, I can do other things by selecting post-estimation. So if I click this, this opens the post-estimation selector. And I can do all kinds of things. I can estimate, calculate tests, contrast, pairwise comparisons. I can calculate predictions and do diagnostic plots. But for now, what I'd like to do is just do a quick graph of my parameters. So I'm going to do an interaction plot here. I've gone to marginal analysis. Marginal means an interaction analysis. Interaction plot, and now I'm going to click launch. So in the main tab here in the margins dialog box, I can select the covariate foreign. And then here below, I'd like to see the interaction analysis with another covariate. That's going to be weight. And I might like to see the weight of the car at 2,000 pounds, 2,500, 3,000, 3,500, and maybe 4,000. And I would also notice that this box here is checked that says draw profile plot of the results. So Stata is going to do that for me after I click OK. I close this box. And now what I can see in the results window here in the background, I can see the predictions, the marginal predictions. And I can see a graph now that shows me the marginal predictions for the automobile's weight being 2,000, 2,500, 3,000, 3,500, and 4,000 pounds, as well as a confidence interval around each of those predictions. And I can customize this graph however I like. I can change the colors. I could change the confidence intervals to confidence bands or whatever I like. There are lots of graphs that are built in for regression and diagnostic plots if I wanted to do this. We're not going to do this at the moment, but they're located under graphics and regression diagnostic plots. The last thing I wanted to show you is that notice that I've used the dialog box for all of my analyses, but I can still come over here to the review window on the left-hand side of Stata. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the first command here, hold down the shift key, and then select the 16th command. So I've highlighted them all, and now I'm going to just right-click anywhere, and I'm going to select Send Selected to Do File Editor. And now what I've done, here it is I've actually saved all of those commands that I generated with the dialog boxes to a do file or a batch file, and I can save this and run it over and over again. So even if, as I said earlier, if you're not a dialog box person, if you prefer to type code and you like the reproducibility of that, in the beginning you can learn by using the dialog boxes and checking various options and things like that. So it makes learning Stata a little bit quicker. So this is just some of the very basic things. We've hardly scratched the surface of what Stata can do. Just under the statistics menu here, you can see what we can fit models for: binary outcomes and ordinal outcomes, categorical outcomes, count outcomes, fractional outcomes, and so forth. And all of these things are included. And if you'd like to learn more about them, you can either select the dialog box. I'm going to click linear regression again here. At the bottom of each dialog box, there's a little question mark. And if I click on that, it will open the help file. Or I can click right under this where it says view complete PDF manual entry, and I can read everything about it, including the methods and formulas, and see more detailed examples. You can search the manuals for keywords by typing search in the command line and then type your keyword and then use the option manual, manual. And this will search the manual for that keyword, or you could search for that keyword in the frequently asked questions by typing search keyword. I'm just searching for regress, and then FAQ, and that will search the frequently asked questions. Or I could search the Stata journal as well. So I could type search regress SJ, and that will search the Stata journal. Or I could just leave off the options and it will search all of Stata's resources for that keyword. So that's just some of the basics to get you started using Stata. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.